हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू ई लर्निंग बाई सेठ छोटेलाल अकेडमी जाज। आफ्टर ए लॉन्ग ब्रेक अगेन वी आर हियर जस्ट टू रीड चैप्टर 4 एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज क्यूब एंड क्यूब रूट्स। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक्स व्हाट आर क्यूब्स, परफेक्ट क्यूब, एग्जामाइन अ नंबर बीइंग परफेक्ट क्यूब and properties of cubes of numbers. So let's start today. For cubes, so let's understand what are cubes. Cubes are numbers, we can say cubes are natural numbers. 27 I have written a number and it is a cube because it is found after the multiplying a number 3 times by itself. Generally we can say that if a number is multiplied by itself 3 times, then what number or what result we get, that is called a perfect cube. So 27 is a perfect cube because it is found after multiplying 3 times by itself. So this is the we can say the definition of cubes. So it is very easy to search the cubes. When we want a cube number, we will have to multiply a natural number 3 times by itself and then only we can get. So 1 is the cube of 1. When we multiply 2 3 times, we will get 8. So 8 is the cube of 2. So children, so many cubes numbers are there because natural numbers are infinite. So many cubes are there. I suggest you just to remember cubes of 1 to 10 always. Now let's move to our next topic, that is perfect cube. So what are perfect cubes? We can identify the perfect cube. Suppose a number is given to us as 24. And we need to check that 24 is a perfect cube or not. So what will we do? We will do the prime factorization of 24. 24 we have written and we do the prime factorization. It should be reduced by 2 first, 12, then again by 2, 6, again by 2, 3, again by 3. Now we see that we have got 2, 2, 2 and 3. So 24 can be factorized as 2 multiply 2 multiply 2 multiply 3. Here we can see that number 2 3 times, but number 3 is only 1 time. In a perfect cube, whenever you will do the prime factorization, you will get any number at least 3 times, or the multiple of 3 times. It should be 6 times, it should be 9 times, because we will have to gather the number 3 times for having this number a perfect cube. If we are not getting the number or all the numbers 3 times in prime factorization, so it means that the given number is not a perfect cube. So this number 24 is not a perfect cube. Let's identify another number, that is 64. Okay, do the prime factorization of 64. 2, 32. 2 again, that 16. 2 again, 8. 2 again, 4 ja. 2, 2 ja. And 2, 1 ja. What we have got here, you can see 3 times 2, again 3 times 2. So this 3 times 2 and 3 times 2, we can write it here as the prime factorization so 3 times and 3 times. There is no number which we have found less than 3 times or more than 3 times. So it is 2 only 2 is present on the in the prime factorization of 64, and we have got it 3 times and 3 times. So this number 64 is a perfect cube. Here in 24 we have got a number 3 that is not 3 times in its prime factorization. So we can say that 24 is not a perfect cube and 64 is a perfect cube. Now we will go to next topic, examine a number being perfect cube. Okay children, nothing to understand else we have done here for this topic also, examine a number being perfect cube. A number will be perfect cube only if its factors we are getting in the group of 3. A number should come in the prime factorization at least 3 times or the multiples of 3 times whenever it will be a perfect cube. So this topic is covered here only. Now we will go for the fourth topic, that is properties of cubes of numbers. So children, we read in this topic properties of cubes of numbers, some facts about the cubes. What are the facts? I can show you. The first fact is the cube of a negative integer will always be negative because we have to multiply the negative number 3 times. So minus sign should also comes in the product 3 times. So the result will be negative. As seen, the cube of a positive number or natural number we can say, that is a positive number always. So these are the two facts. Our third fact is the cube of all odd numbers is always odd whenever we multiply. I can show you it here, that 3, we know that it is an odd number. So if we multiply 3 times, 27 we will get, and it is also an odd number. So cube of an odd number will always be odd. And our fourth fact, cube of all even numbers will be always even. We can take any of the even number. Suppose we have taken 2, 3 times when we multiply 2 we will get 8. So cube of an even number always be an even number, and cube of an odd number will always be an odd number. So these are some facts. You can study also it by your books that you are provided also already. So this is the video for cube and cube roots. I have covered 4 topics. In my next video I will cover rest of the topic of the chapter. And I think you are studying in your home. Children, don't waste your time because circumstances are not in our favor, but it doesn't mean that we will waste our time. We will have to improvise our study, our pronunciation related to every subject so that we may improve ourselves. So what should we do? We will have to study books and watch videos that school is providing to you and increase your knowledge, enhance your knowledge this time. Okay children, bye.